There's obviously the pressure for house prices. You factor in things like migration and just the overall supply and demand factors too. But particularly when it comes to keeping up with that demand, Peter, the pressures on the construction industry are really immense at the moment. I've been speaking to representatives of the industry throughout the day. The latest figures that we have are the cost of materials, so the nuts and bolts, the wood, the steel you need to build a home, are up 33% in the past 5 years. The cost of just doing business, of actually building the home, when you factor in labour and everything else, up 40% in 5 years. So it's an incredibly difficult industry to make a buck in. The Master Builders Association, their latest numbers say you need about 500,000 more tradies to meet the government's target of 1.2 million new homes in the next 5 years, which is already behind schedule, looking more and more like a wish and a hope and a prayer by the day. The other factor, of course, is productivity, still trying to get out of a ditch on that front across the economy. But within sectors like construction, there's still a strong reservation about the impact of changes to industrial relation laws. Yes, the government is thrilled that wages are ticking up, and for individual workers, that is a significant deal. But when you add that, wages rising, to the pressures of other things like construction costs and other factors too, even if it might be better for the worker, it makes it incredibly difficult to make a buck in those sort of sectors. So a very difficult compounding calamity, if you like, or a conundrum of needing more people to build homes, not having enough homes for them to live in, and not having enough homes for others to live in as well. So it's that catch-22 the government's trying to solve.